Then we'll start again the demonstration of QDA miner Lite yesterday's session. Okay. So I will go to the, so I have saved that file which we made yesterday. So I hope all of you have saved your file too. Have you imported all those 14 transcript in the QDA miner Lite yesterday and give it a name? Did you do it? Please write in the chat box. I cannot see. Yes. Anuradha is writing yes. No. Parul. Mrinalini, yes. Jennifer, yes. Parul, then do it today. You can do it today also, because then you will not be able to do the hands-on. But you got only 12. That's okay. Even if it is 12, that's okay. It is just a process. If you are able to do it with 12, you will be able to handle 25 or whatever, 6, 4. And we have talked that it is not the number which is important. It is the richness of the transcript which is important. Even a 8 to 10 very rich transcript will work. But even 30 transcript without having a rich text will not work. So it is the richness, not the number, which matters. So now I'll start showing the So let me share the screen. So I have opened this file and clicked on this use free edition. And you can see yesterday we saw that there were three windows. This is the case window, this is the variable window, and this is the code window. Since we have not created the code, this is right now, there is nothing here in this window. Now, like Dr. Surender is saying that he has received only 12 and he has imported all that 12 altogether. But now we send 4 more transcript to him and we ask him to include those 4 transcript. How he will do that? Because he has already imported it. So if you have started your transcript work using whatever initial number of transcript, if you have started the coding, and you should start it, that's why we advocate. So what you should do, that you should click, if you click on this case, you will see there is an option of adding or appending the case. So we will use, and before that, you can do one thing, that in this, you can hide this full version menu item. Because you don't have the full version, it is the free version, so I hid it. So you have to go to the case and add it. So I'm showing you how to add it. So if you press this add, this option is only to import few more transcript into your existing data. So I'll press add. It will ask for a file, and it is right now, I'll just press OK. So now you can see there is a file with this dash. Let me increase this window. Okay, so can you see this? This is the file which you can see here. This one, this blue strip which is appearing here, it is just dash. So this is one way where you can add the case. Now, what I'll do, that I will go to the, if I want to add the names of the variable in this case, how will I do it? Any prompts, any hints to me? Because I want to add it. Suppose this case is of a female obstetrician who is 42 years old. How will I add the variable here? Spreadsheet. Very good. So you can go to the variable. You can go to the spreadsheet editor. This you can see here. I'll do it is she's a new value. So new value, I may type that she's a maybe HCP 17. And then gender is female. Age is 42. And profession is OBG. So I have selected OBG. And then I will press this apply. So it will be saved. And now you can see female OBG 42.
That HCP, new HCP, how it got added, ma'am? So sorry.
That was already there in the, if you see the variable spread editor, it's HCP healthcare professional. I added that maybe yesterday. Healthcare, you, it is not necessary. You can delete it also. But if you see this identifier, because whatever is appearing here, that will be shown in your case identifier. I'll show you in this case. So first you, have you understood how we have given name to it? So this is the attribute code. I have used the option. Now, if you click this, there is a blank space here. You have to import document here. So what you can do, you can go this window, all these options will work. Whereas in this window, these options will work. So if you have to press this open, and I will go to maybe, I'll go to desktop to import one of the file, maybe that. So that demo file is there. I will open and you can see the file type. The file type is doc. So this will come as a same. So I have pressed this. I'm looking for some file which I can import. So you can see this demo. So this is a Word file. Even if it is a PDF, it will be imported. So I clicked it and I have pressed this open. Okay, because file is being used. So because I will just close this file. So if any file is open, it will not import. So I have closed this file. Now I will have again press this. It comes as an RTF text. So change this to doc and then open. So you will see that researcher X study, which we were reading, think it as a transcript and it has got imported here. So could you understand if you have to add one or two cases? So you have to add those transcripts. Now, if we send you a few more transcripts, you have to add those transcripts one by one. Or you can make a folder again and you can import that. But it is not recommended. You add it one by one because already you have imported one folder. So it will not be imported again. Otherwise, the previous one will, you might lose them. So this is one. Another way to add case is to append case. So like if you, instead of adding case, if you append, if you press this option of append and you press this document, again, this can be done. So in this case, like if I want to add like this demo file, this demo, add, and then append, and then okay. So you will see again, this is again one file which has appeared. So it is inserting this file first and then creating a case here. And in the previous case, what we did, we created case first and then we added the document. So it can be done both ways. Either you can append the transcript first and give variable name later, or you can create case, give a variable name, and then use this option of open and then add it here. Are these two options clear to all of you? How we can add transcripts to existing?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Okay, Jennifer, it's okay. You can learn, maybe you will have the recordings also, so you can learn that. And it is just, you can keep trying, and it is like another software where the more you work, the more you will get comfortable. So this was one thing which I wanted to show you, Then again, there is one more option. In case, if you go to, no, there was one option, which was the, this grouping or descriptor. So this descriptor, if you click this, you can see this, you can add. This is, this has taken gender, age, and profession. And if you will import the verbatim for write-up, then this will show with this. If you want to add any new variable, like I may delete it, everything. You can see the formatting. All the variables are in the double bracket, curly bracket we call. Not double bracket, curly bracket. And it is connected by dash. If I remove all this, and I want only gender to be there. So what I'll do? I will click this and I will apply this. So you can see all the identifier that age and occupation, it got lost. It is only gender. Now I want one more, that may be the age. So I put a dash here, age. So it, age has appeared here and I have put this, this apply. So you can see now female is there and age is also there. And if I want to add profession also, then I'll click this. But since I have not put a dash, it has not appeared. So in between these two, you have to put a dash. And then apply. So you can see here now, male 65 and eye specialist. So this option, and then this is apply. So now it will be there. So I have closed this window. So this option comes from the case. And by using this option of grouping or descriptor. Okay. So we have learned two commands today. One is the add case or append case. And then we learned few more. This was the grouping editor. You can use the descriptor according to your need. I have just used these three. But if you are like doing a qualitative research on dot provider or on Asha, A&M, so you can write a descriptor. Asha, which block, which district, or Asha, which PHC, under which MOIC, depends on what descriptor you want to add. So that you can do depending on your need and the subject of choice which you interview. So this is the concept of descriptor and adding the case. Now I'll start the coding process. So here you can see there is one transcript. And you can see that the code window is here. So in the coding, what you do, you start with the, this, before I start coding it, I have done manual coding on one or two transcripts. So I'm clear in my mind, rough codes are there in my mind. Or even if you don't want to have a code coding initially, you, what you can do, you can start reading here only. If you don't have time to take printout and if don't want to waste time in, you know, because we are now working, all of us are now working on soft copies. So you can read the transcript here also. But generally, if you do it, that is the best way. So I've started this coding and here I've read that it is the after post graduation. I worked 6 months at Apollo Hospital. Then I worked Delhi government. So maybe I will code this, the whole sentence. As a work experience. So you select this. And then if you go by this option, codes, then it will, and I am adding code. So what I have done, I will give the name of this code. What is the code? Maybe I'm writing here as work experience. And then in this QDA minor light, This will not be added unless you define a category. But if I'm going inductively, I don't have any category now. So I will write it as an open code. So open code is not a category, but because I have to write something here, otherwise this will not be enabled because then it needs a category. So if you are going deductively, if you already have categories in your mind, then you can start putting that category here. Or you can put open or you can type anything so that it will be, this will be enabled. And this is for the color, but we don't change the color. It is red, so I leave it like that. And then you can press add. So if you have pressed add, you will see that the code has appeared, but it is not showing here. So what I'll do, if you double click this, if you select this again and double click, you can see there is an appearance of this code here, like work experience, like you people did on the MS Word, bracketing and then using the code. Or it can be done by another way. So what I'll do, I will, the second example I will show with another way. In this case, like I am sharing my private practice here, and this is the load. He is saying that 3 to 4 patients daily, these many patients. So if I just want to do these codes as a patient load. So you can see I'm coding 4 sentences is one. So exactly not, but this is a type of lumper coding. So I'll go. In this case, you can see there is an icon, this green pen-like icon is there with a plus sign. So if you click, the again same window will appear. So you can write here the patient load. And again, I have kept it in the open category. In the description, you can describe about this code. But generally, we don't do, because writing so much of description, if you wish that, if you're sending this file to someone whom you want an expert opinion, then you may write some description of the code. And then you can press here. So again, you can see there is an appearance of this code. So this can be done by two ways. The more convenient is select and then press this green one. Like in this case, you can see consultancy, this I have read this. Complain, what is the history, what they have taken. I spent 5 minutes to examine the patient, if he's suffering from knee arthritis, why this disease happened. Then I explained them the probable cause of this. So maybe if I code it like consultancy time, this 5 minutes language and all, and that's how I discuss about the patient, what treatment. So maybe I can write it as a, so if I have to do coding of this part, how should I go? Either I can go by code or I can use this option. But if you go by code, you have to double click that particular again. So in this case, you press this code and again, I may write consultancy quality because it is the time and what services. This is again in the open code and I have pressed this OK. So this is the consultancy quality. So these are few codes. Now I will show you a few more actions what you can do with these. Like in this case, I'll repeat few more codes. Here he's saying that I am telling you about my recent experience when started my practice in Mokama. I started practice in Mokama. He's repeating the same. That's what I have written. He came to me and told me that he's having knee pain and body ache. But when I observed his overall look based on my experience and knowledge about HIV, it appeared to me that the patient is HIV positive. So what I can write here, that this is the provisional diagnosis from the look. He is saying that he came to me. So I may write it. What I will do again, I will press this green pen, green plus icon. I may write it provisional diagnosis by appearance. Diagnosis by appearance. And then I have pressed OK. If I go down again, you can see perhaps he was having chest infection for many days and has been suffering from fever. I got his screening test for HIV done. So I may write like symptoms of disease. So I will press this and I may write this symptoms of disease. Okay. So this way, by clicking these option, you can select the code. This one. Any doubt up till this point, then I will tell you the next command. So I will summarize once again what we have discussed. We have discussed the adding of new cases by these two options. Either we can use the option of add case. If we click this option of add case, a blank line will appear. You have to go and give variable name using that spreadsheet editor, and then in this here in this window, you can use this option of open, and then you can import that. Or the second thing what you can do, you can go and click on this append document. If you click this append document, first the document will be attached, and then you can add the description of that particular case here. Then we have seen this grouping and descriptor, where you can use the variable depending on your choice, which you want to show in your manuscript. And then we have seen how to do the coding. So coding, you can go by this codes, or you can use this option and you can keep on doing the coding. Anything which you need, any explanation or re-explanation or any doubts up till this point?
I just want to ask, what if we want to change the code? One code that is, I'm thinking that once we are doing this coding thing, I am putting one code, for example, like patient load.
Yes, I know.
And so, like that, and then I want to change that wording, that patient load. So what do I need to do?
You want to select some other verbatim for that code.
Yes.
There is an option of, if you go to the code, there is an option of edit code. So like if I have selected this, if this is the code, like this is a symptom of disease. So I may select this because I have told you that these actions will be performed for these windows. So I have selected this, I'll go to the code, and I'll then you can see all these options are enabled. So if you edit this, you can change the name of the code for the same sentence. Like initially it was simple. Then I may add like whatever. I'm just typing anything. So you can change it. Right now I'll again make symptoms of disease.
Okay.
Any other query? Like in one paragraph, if you want to code it, like let me come to some, like in here in this case, I have written it, I've done it as a lumpa coding. Maybe complain what is the history from where they have taken the treatment, what investigations was done earlier. Then I spend 5 minutes to examine when he's suffering from knee, why this disease happened. Because when the patient has, so I may write it like probable cause of disease. So I may use the code here, like explaining the patient for the disease, cause of disease. Either you can do the in vivo coding, but it doesn't take that sentence. In in vivo software, it takes that sentence and it codes, but here you have to type it. Cause of disease. And then again, you can click. So you can see under this broad, then again, there's a small code. And here also, I try to explain in their language about the disease. So you can write here, analytical reflection, you can write. So you can code this. I try to explain in their language about the disease. So I may write that doctor is concern of the doctor for patient. And then I may click it. So you can add, you can try doing coding each sentence, or you can do a lumpa coding, depends on your way, how you want to do it. So now you can, like this concern for doctor, I want to write some analytical memo. So how I will write? So because while going through this, I was thinking that this doctor is so nice, and you know, he is taking that much of effort to maintaining, to explaining the cause of disease in the patient language and not thinking about the loss of time. So maybe I will write, do this right click, and then you can see there is a comment section. So I have, there's a comment. So in comment also, you can see there are various color coding. This yellow is for reflection. This green is to keep. This again green for further discuss. This purple is to need review. If you need review, need to review it, you click this. This is warning, and this is again the miscellaneous. So I want to write my reflection. So what I will write here, the doctor was showing concern towards patient and not bothering about the maybe wastage of time. So we said in the analytical memo that it is a dumping ground of your brain. So like at this time, this is coming to my mind that the doctor is so good. He's not thinking that why to explain and all these things. So all these things, you may write it and then you close it. So if you close it, there is a yellow, this band appears here. Can you see this yellow color? So with a code, whenever this yellow color band is attached, that means there is a memo with it, analytical memo. Similarly, come down and I may show you a few more codes. Like in this case, actually we explain about them. Testing is a part of preoperative investigations when they never ask any questions and agree for the test. So maybe this is a sort of mandatory test. So I may write it, give it a code of mandatory testing. So mandatory testing for HIV. It is an open code and click. And then again, I may write here analytical memo, because I by reading this sentence, I was thinking that why this is mandatory, because the program, the HIV program is not recommending it. So this is because this has come to my mind. That's why I have written like this. Why it is mandatory? Because the program is not recommending it. And then you can press this. So I have written this analytical memo here. And then similarly, you can go down and you can keep on doing the code. One more option here, which I want to show. If you want to increase or decrease this selected text, then again, what you can do, go to this right click and there is an option of resize. So if you select this, there are two options here, start of the segment and end of the segment. In the start of the segment, if you click this, this will see this purple color. This has this is going to increase. If you press this, this is going to decrease. Again, end of the segment, if you want to increase or decrease the selection of the verbatim, then you can use these options. And this comes by doing the right click over this code and using the option of resize. Is it clear up till this point or any ambiguities there?
Yes, ma'am.
Clear, Anuradha?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So if it is clear, then I'm not going to show you the whole this thing, because it is very individual, and we will see. No, I have already coded it as a in a sheet, and I'll show you in the after this breakout room how you can do from category, from the codes, how you can merge it into a category. So I'll show you. Let me close this. No, I don't want to save it. And this is my, I have already coded it. Otherwise it will take too much time here. So you can see I have used the open code here. So this is my code book. And these many codes are there. And if you see the transcript, I have not coded the entire transcript. Maybe there are 7 transcripts, but I have coded, I think, only 3-4. So you can see these are the total codes. And then we will see how to make category. And this is my code book. So you can take a printout of this code book, because in one view, or you can enlarge, if you enlarge this view also, this will be not be covered. If your codes are very large, you will not be able to see it. You have to scroll it down. So what is the best way? You should take a printout of this code book. There is an option, if you go to the codes and you, if you press this option of print code book, if you click this, then there are various options. You want separate category. If you have a category here, it will give you one page for each category. You want to start new page on a category or anything. So these options are there, and you can use a, or if you can use it alphabetically also. And that is, yes, any question? No. So this is the way to print the code book, and you should get the code book printed, because when you are making the category, if you can mute Anuradha, yeah. So this is one way to doing that category thing, because in one view, you cannot see the whole code. So it is difficult for you to make them into categories. So if you have got a printout of the code book, and then you can do the code, putting the codes into the category. There is one more way how we can do it in the Excel sheet after you have got these code book, that we'll see in the next session. So Shreyas, and now what you have to do, those of you, please open the breakout room, Shreyas, and all the mentors, it is requested that you please ask participant to share their screen, because we have demonstrated and we have shown them twice all the commands. So unless and until they do it, they will not be able to understand. So let them do it. You only facilitate. This I have shown you before you went to the breakout room. This is the whole code book. And you can see there are many codes here. So if you start making category using this code, it might not be very easy for you to do it. So what I do, there are individual ways of doing it. And if you have gone through the transcript many times, and when you are coding also, if some categories coming to your mind, you can decide those categories. So first, before you move to the formation of category, you can merge the codes. And you can do that cleaning of the codes. But again, I'll say that if you don't want to waste time over that, because many times you don't report the codes, then you can maybe do it later also. It is up to you. So what you can do, I've shown you the list of the codes, and I've shown you how to take a print of it. So I will go to this codes. If you see this codes, there is an option of sort code book also. So if you click this sort code book, so it will ask that, do you want to arrange both codes and category? I have written yes, because there is no category now. You can see that it has been arranged on the basis of alphabets, like alphabetical arrangement. In this case, it is easy for you to trace any duplicate code. In this case, I'll show you, like I have written here, mandatory testing not practiced universally, mandatory testing relieves the stress. Mandatory testing for protection as a healthcare professional. Again, so these can be clubbed together as mandatory testing. So similar looking words will also come together if you arrange it like a code book. Again, I have coded while I was doing the code. I have, like you can see that, these two things, referral to higher centers. And then again, I have code like referral to tertiary care center. So while I was doing it, I did not pay attention, and I have given two codes to it. So what you can do, you can merge the code. So what you go select this, go to the codes and merge into. So it will ask merge into which. So you can select this referral to higher center. It will be maybe merge into the tertiary care center. Okay. Then press yes. And then you can see that it is only one code now, referral to tertiary care center. So that's how you can refine your codes based on the similar looking. again, separate ward for HIV people, separate clinic for HIV patients. You can merge these two also, that separate facility. So that you can do this, go to the code, merge into, again, this you have to scroll down. So it is from the S. So if you have arranged it alphabetically, it is easy for you to locate also. So I will write separate clinic and separate ward. So maybe separate clinic. And you can press OK. And later you can edit also. Means like I want to rename this code. So like Ria was asking, I may go to the code and I will press this edit. And instead of clinic, I may write it here, separate facility for patients. And then I press OK. So I have renamed this code. So by renaming, by the option of edit code, you can refine your code, whatever NVivo code you have given initially. If by going through the dictionary, thesaurus, synonym, if you find suitable word, few words which can replace a sentence, then also you can edit the code and you can refine your code. Did you get it? Now, once you have done it, again, I've shown you how to take the print of it. So go to the codes, print code book, and it should be like, I've not taken anything. So this is the one, and you can make a, if you click on print, any device. So here you can see that there is a PDF version. So by this printing is, this printing got on, so it got printed. But again, there's an option, I cannot see that option of PDF. In this Microsoft Word, this was there. So you print it, and then maybe I have saved it in my desktop. File name, I can write it as codebook. Codebook _HIV. Saved it. I have gone to the desktop. This is my code book for HIV. So these are my codes. Now what I have done, I have copied all these codes into an Excel sheet. So you can see these Excel sheets. Can you see it? This is the Excel sheet, and if you scroll it down, you can see there are various codes. So there are approximately 58 codes now. In 58 codes, I have to now make a category. So what I find useful, that I make like 3-4 categories and I don't give a name to the category because I'm not sure what name to be given. So I just start putting the codes into one category, which the codes which are similar looking. Like in this case, difficult to screen for HIV in CAM surgery. The difficulty in diagnosis due to performance pressure. So maybe I can put it into the difficulties or the challenges faced by the healthcare worker. So I will control and cut this, and maybe I have pasted it here in category 4. So I have pasted this here, and I may give it a name of challenges. You may change the name of the category. Challenges. You can give a full name like challenges faced by healthcare professional. Then again, difficulty in diagnosis due to performance pressure. Again, I have cut it and I have pasted it here. Discrimination should not be done. So this I can put it as a discrimination. So maybe in one more category, because I have given few category here. So I have pasted it here. Again, division of consultancy time. This I'm not sure where to put. Extra cost of surgery. This can you be, I have one category which I have decided, barriers in treatment. So I can do this, that there are, so I have cut it and I have pasted it here. Then facility of disinfection in the district hospital, fixed days of surgery. This is not coming. Testing, HIV testing based on symptom, increased cost of surgery. Again, this is increased cost and extra cost. These are the similar looking thing. So I have pasted it here. Fear of contracting the disease, healthcare professional. So these are the maybe reason of refusal. So maybe I have pasted it here. That's why they are refusing. HIV testing based on symptom. So this I may put it here in the testing strategy. That in testing strategy, it is done based on the symptoms. So I pasted it here. Increase security in the surgeon. So maybe I may write that, you know, mandatory testing causes increased security. So I have written indirect refusal at the tertiary care center. So I may put it here, refusal. Information given to the patient on his disease condition. This I'm not sure where to put, so I will leave it like that. Involvement of private clinic is difficult to do, unavailability of trained staff. These are the challenges which we have written here, challenges faced by the healthcare professional in category 5, this one. So this I have pasted here. Again, I'll go down and see the codes. Information given to patient on his disease. Disease are having high social stigma. So maybe this is one of the reason for refusal. So I've kept here as a reason for refusal. Again, I may refine this category. I may write it as reason for refusal. Then mandatory testing before undergoing surgery. Mandatory testing not practiced universally. So I may write it here as the testing strategy. So I have kept it like this. So this way, if you cut and paste the code in one category, the codes which are similar looking, it is not necessary that you define category in the beginning, because while you are putting the codes in a one category, even if you have not given the name of the category, later you may decide that, you know, what name you should be giving to that category. But first task is to club those codes into similar looking concept and give some rough name, and then you may decide for a refined category. So did you get it? How to make codes into the category?
Ma'am, can you please explain once again how we are opening the codes in this Excel sheet?
Okay. So actually, if you have got the full version, then you can import this code book as a CSV file, okay, as an Excel file also. But in this free version, this option is not there. So what we do, or what is recommended, that you go to this codes option. You have seen this sort code book. Sort it alphabetically, because this will help you in selecting the code and in merging the code. So you sort it using this option of sort. Press yes, then again go to the codes. There's option of print code book. Print this, and there is option of Microsoft. Here there are many options, but you know that Microsoft to print PDF. Yeah. So this PDF, you can select, and you can do that like in one column. So this you can select here. It is the number of column 2. So you can do it like one column. In the one column, it is easy for you to copy and paste. So if you reduce the number of column to 1 and then press print. So again, I have shown that this is, maybe I have kept it with name of something DFHJ and saved it. Again, I'll go back to the desktop. This is code book. I have opened it, and then you can see it is in the one column. Okay. And then you can copy it from here. And then you can See, you can copy it.
Okay, just copy. We will copy it. Okay, ma'am.
Yeah, copy. And then you can paste it on the Excel sheet.
Okay.
Here in the Excel sheet. Because in the free version, there are many things. All the options are not there.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you
and
so
then
much.
I have pasted it here in the one column. And then again, that is very important that if you are not sure what to give the what name to be given to a category, you can just write category 1, 2, 3, and 4 and start putting the codes into the respective category, the similar looking codes. Any other questions before I move ahead? Any query to anyone? So like I have now decided that these are my category, and then you can again take a print of this, or maybe you can have separately opening, but no, that won't work two things simultaneously, because this spreads in a horizontal section, and that in QDA also you don't have the option of opening two windows. So you take a print of now this category. Now you again go back here. And now you can name these categories. So initially everything is open code. So now if I like avoidance in first instance, so I'll again go to the code, edit code. And here I can write under the open code, this if I have coded the category, if I have coded it like maybe refusal, because it is saying that avoidance in first instance. So it is refusal. And maybe it is the direct refusal or indirect. I'm just writing refusal, then maybe later you can decide whether it was a direct refusal or it was an indirect refusal. So I have written refusal and then press OK. So once you have pressed OK, it appears, the category appears at the last. Then you can see these three categorical, this is the variable sign for a categorical variable. So this sign is there and this refusal is there and avoidance in the first instance is there. Again, I'll start doing it to all the other variables with the help of that Excel sheet which I have. Or if you are very well versed, you have read the transcript many times, and if you have done some preliminary work, you can directly create category here. But for beginners, or if you have got many codes, like here it was only 50 codes, 58, because I did coding only for three transcripts. That's why the number of codes are less. Maybe if you code and if you do the extensive splitter coding, then the number of codes will be large. In that case, if you use that Excel sheet, it is easy for you. And then you can either drag and drop, like in this case, I'll go code-wise. So this now assuring the patient to the surgery will be done free of cost. No, I am not sure whether to put it availability of testing facility in the periphery. So this I will testing strategy if I want to code it. So I will go to the edit, and instead of open code, I will write it as a testing strategy. After you put, category, then if like extra cost of patient surgery, if you do the edit code from the drop-down menu, you can see these category. So you can select the existing category which you have given already. So because there is a drop-down menu. So extra cost of HIV patient. This may be acting as a barrier in their treatment. So I will write in their barrier in the treatment. And then I pressed OK. So you can see the number of categories at the last. Refusal, testing strategy, barrier in the treatment. And then again, like availability of drugs and investigations, avoiding complicated surgery. So either you use the drag and drop, but many times, you know, taking this variable so down to here, it is not very, I don't find it very comfortable. So I use the option of edit and I go for this because it is easy for me. So this avoiding complicated surgery, I'll go as a barrier in the treatment. So I will press this, I will select this. Double click this and then OK. If the number of codes are less, or if you have to move this code here, maybe work experience, vast experience, no use of disposable for surgery. This is again treatment, training on rotation. This is test should be done in privacy. So if this is very near to this category, so I may use this drop down menu. This will be in the testing strategy. So if you press this and drop it here, this has appeared here. But moving this first code to the last category, many times you my control of mouse is not very good. So I drop in between. So that's why I use the option of this edit code. So then you go to the edit and come again, testing should be done in privacy. This though I have written, maybe this HCP fear of contracting the disease. So go to the code, edit, select a category. So this is refusal. Or maybe barrier. And then okay. Similarly, information availability at private center, indirect refusal at tertiary care center. So this is again, go to the edit. It is refusal. So it is refusal. Double click this. Okay. So you can see there is code is now proliferating into the respective category. And now you can move respective codes to their categories. Or if you feel like, you can have more categories. So I am now closing this. I don't want to save this, as I have already done this, moved all these codes into their respective categories. But before you move your codes to the respective categories, please save your code book, the raw code. Because that is like your variable, that is like your continuous variable. Later you might need to change the category, then all that raw code will be lost. So make a copy of a QDA file, maybe like I have done it, stage 1, stage 2, stage 3. So you may make a QDA file stage 1 or the beginning stage and save it. And then have a copy of it and then work on the other file and then keep naming those file, because at every stage you are moving. So we don't want you to get lost in the initial, because once you are move all the codes into the respective category, and then again, it is very difficult to move back to the main code. So that's why have one copy of the initial code book in the form of maybe the initial analysis or just coding, and then save it. At least if you want to share it with someone and you want their opinion regarding the code book, that person can do it independently. So that is also one advantage. So you can see I have made how many categories. If you see the drop down menu, maybe I will go the code, see the codes and do the option of editing and then see. So I have these many categories, like ways to tackle the refusal, discrimination. There is again subcategory under this discrimination, selective discrimination. Refusal also I have divided like indirect refusal and direct refusal. And then there are barrier in treatment and care of HIV patient, testing strategy and communication, treatment strategy. And then you can see there are few codes which are not fitting into any of these category. So it will happen to you also that there will be these many codes, I'm clueless where to fit. So that's why I have left it. So you can delete these codes also, or you can leave it as such. Because if you don't want the categorization of this, you can leave it as such. So are you clear up till this point, how you can use the option of edit code to make a category? And one more thing I forgot to tell, in the edit code, if you go, there is an option of, like in this treatment strategy. How that option was coming, that sub, okay. Yes, in that what you do, under category, you select a category. Like in treatment category or in the refusal, in the treatment category, if I have to, that is a description of how I made two category na, in this selective and direct and indirect. Yes, I took one more this thing now. So I have gone to this refusal. Yeah, just a sec. Can you see there is a refusal and referral? And then there is an indirect refusal and direct refusal. So if anything I want to make, I'll show you with a fresh one. Like barriers. I want to make a subcategory of it. So what I'll do, difficulty in diagnosis due to, I'll go to the edit code. And here in the barrier in treatment and care, I want to make a subcategory. So what I'll do, I'll do a down slash here. So I'll do a down slash here. Can you see a down slash? And maybe I can write here direct barrier. Direct barrier. And then I will press OK. So you can see under this barrier, there is a direct barrier. So by using the option of down slash, you can create a subcategory in the main category. Is it clear to you? This option, this I forgot to tell you people. So this you can do. So once you are clear with this, now I will show you the analysis part. How to retrieve the codes and how to do the code frequency analysis and the word map. Any difficulty up till this point? Can you guide me? I can't see the chat box. Can you show me?
No, ma'am.
Oh, thank you. Thank you, Surendra Devayam.
No, ma'am. It's fine.
Okay. Then I'll go to the, now, once you are done with this, so now you can see the analysis, analyze. Do you want break? What is the house opinion? Bhavna is writing, Mugdha is a 5 minutes, 5 minutes. Okay, I'm here only. You people can go and come after 5 minutes. But I think they are right that we did not announce. Actually, we thought that we'll finish by, Ria is also saying, continue Mugdha, what to do? See, we can discuss the other people. I'll again show the commands.
And we can end early, ma'am.
Yeah, that's true. But people who cannot concentrate, I will repeat the command. Those of you who can want to go for, you can go for 2-3 minutes. We can have some chit chat in between if you are bugged up with this. I mean, maybe very tired. Or you can, what? So 2 minutes break in between. And either 5 minutes nor no break. So actually, we can just talk. Any experience which you want to share? Mugdha, Anuradha, Jennifer, and
ma'am, may I?
Yeah, please.
Ma'am, this has really helped. This workshop has really helped me to understand the qualitative part of the research, because in our department we have had many mixed method researchers, but qualitative analysis was not done properly at all. Now we are having, in the next month, we are having a workshop conducted by our department. So I am able to understand how to present these things and how to do the analysis. And I'm really grateful that I got to attend this workshop. So thank you so much, ma'am.
Thank you, dear. Thank you so much. And we just want that you should be benefited by us. And you can, even if you want to make any presentation, all the PowerPoint and all the materials are there with you people. You can disseminate the same knowledge and information wherever you people are. You can use those material. Anything which you want to use, you can use. You are free to use that.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you so much, ma'am.
Yes, it's our
pleasure. Excuse me, ma'am.
Yeah.
Ma'am, how to code the analytical memo?
Okay, we'll come to that. Analytical memo also, just hold for 5 minutes. In the analysis section, now I'll show you. There is a, if you go to that coding, we'll show you the coding frequency there, you can get it. Analytical memo coding, either you can do two things here. In the free version, you can have all analytical memo copy pasted at one document and then you can code it. Or you can have that with you while you are drafting the manuscript, you can use that there also. But in this case, since field notes also, what we did that you can copy all field notes at one point and we can make it like a transcript file and you can import that also. And in that variable section, if you go, I'll just show. This is the, I'll just hide full version menu. If you go to the analyze,
Ma'am, you are muted.
Sorry. So I was just showing that. You go to the analyze coding frequency. In the coding frequency, if you press this option of search, and I'll maximize this. So can you see all these codes are here? Number of how many times it has appeared. So you can see the number of counts are less because I have not refined these codes. Maybe if you refine these codes, there are a few codes which are appearing thrice, twice, one time, but most of the codes are only appearing one because I have not refined this codes. So once you merge this, once you refine your codes, obviously this frequency, this will be less and it will be compressed to like maybe 20, 25. Although I have used only 4 transcript or 3 transcript for coding purpose. And this is the percentages here. So this is the coding frequency and percentages. Now, how to retrieve the code segment, code segment? Because once you are going to write your manuscript, you need the code to support your category. So for that, you go to this treatment. Suppose I want to write this category of treatment strategy. So I will right click this, press on this select item and select this. So once you select this, all the codes under this category of treatment strategy get selected. And after that, you do this right click and you press this option of retrieve segment. So if you press this option of retrieve segment, you can see here that all the codes along with the cases. So you can see here, these are the like male orthopedic surgeon, all that variable which we have, which we did in the curly bracket. It is appearing here. And then this is the text. So this is in one line. If you want to enlarge this view, you click this and it will be enlarged. And here you can see the words also. So this is the code. So if you want to copy paste this codes, like you will select those codes which are very different, which like we said, you should select those which show some trouble, some pain, some shift, some recurring pattern in the code. So if I want to this thing, like for HIV patient, the medicine are available here and there is only one center here. So there is only one center. So if I want to select this code, I will go right click and I will, there is an option of copy to clipboard. There is an option of this selection. So select this selection and you can open a, like this is a Word file where I'm writing my manuscript. So maybe this is just that demo file which I have used. So maybe you can come here and you can paste it. Sorry, this one. So for HIV related patients, and in the bracket, this is set by this person because I have selected it. So this is set by male eye specialist 65. So you can write it here in the Word document. Male maybe ophthalmologist. Sorry, I have typed it here. Maybe 65 or 45, what was the age? So that you can write here. What, ma'am, some software terms like grounding or density appears. Please clarify these terms. Sometimes value like this are shown 0, 1. 0, 1 actually in QDA it is not showing. Maybe grounding, density, word density appears here definitely. Like if you go to this charting thing and if you select this option, you can see this like use of disposable equipment disinfection. So the font size shows that how many times that particular code or the particular code has appeared. So this option is there. but like grounding or density, maybe in which software, Hussain, can you specify? Because I hope that you must have done it. 01? Am I audible to you? Atlas TI. Okay. Atlas TI of late, because I use NVivo maybe. So I have not tried it. Maybe we will explore it and we'll let you know. But no, right now we are focusing on it. We will explain this tomorrow. Let's continue with the session today. So should I repeat?
Loading frequency, just show once, ma'am. Just
okay. Yeah, I'm repeating. So I'll close this window. So go to the first from help section, hide the full version menu items. Because then only those items which are available in this free version, that will appear. And it will protect you from seeing here and there and seeing other options. So go to analyze and can you see there is a coding frequency? Click on this coding frequency. And in coding frequency, this dialog box will appear. You just have to press this search. So press this search. I'm not showing you the retrieval specific. Do it just the way I'm saying it. And then maybe we can explore other options. But first, learn the basic one. There are many ways of doing things, but I'm explaining you the most basic one. Once you learn this, then like other software, you can explore other options as well. So this is the coding frequency. Now this gives you the coding frequency for all the category which I have made here.
Nana, I have a worker coming. They are coming for 2-3 days. So I will pick
up. Oh, they go by mistake. And then if I want to select it, like I want to use this category, I'm doing my write-up for this category, barriers in treatment and care of HIV patient. So I will right-click this category and I will press this select item. So if I select this, all the selection item appears. So I want for this category now, I have checked this category and then again, I will do the right-click. So twice right click, one right click for selecting, the second right click for the retrieve segment. So if I have pressed retrieve segment, many times it doesn't work. Let me check. Retrieve segment. It is taking some time. So what I'll do, I'll again, it happens in free version that. So what I'll do, I'll again close this and you do the same thing. So I don't want to save any changes. So I'll press this no, because I have saved this file here as a demo. I've again opened it, use free edition. It gets freeze sometimes. So whatever command you are showing, it will not execute commands which you are putting. Again, I will come to this help. I will hide the full version menu. I'll go to the analyze, coding frequency, press this option of search. All these coding frequency appears. Now I want this under maybe treatment strategy category. I have selected this, select this. Again, second time right click, retrieve segment. And now see, it will come. So see, initially it got freeze. It was not coming, but now it has come. By clicking this option, it will give you a view. So if you press this, this view will be, and you are now able to see whole sentences. So this is the category, this is the code, this is the case, and this is the text, this is the frequency. Again, you can, if you select this, right click this, if you copy, use this selection, and then you can save it over the Word. So that's how you can write, you can use the particular code of this person, male eye specialist, 65 year. Is it clear to you up till this point, or should I repeat it once again? Okay, thank you. Now, what I'll do, this you have seen. So next action is, if you go back to the code frequency, this was the code frequency. So there are a few options here which you can explore. So there is an option of this chart. So if you click this chart selected item, sometimes you must have seen many people, they give the word map. How many times that word appearing in that particular category. So if you click this, then you can see that these are the word map for this particular thing. And then again, this is the pie, although we don't use this pie and bar because it is more of quantitative. But if you are doing a content analysis, purely content analysis of the already published content, then you can use this. Like you have seen the depth, especially that summation content analysis, then you can use that. So any other command which I need to convey? I think that this is the only important thing.
Ma'am, please show how to make charts again.
Okay, so in this code frequency, you can see this is a coding frequency. If you click this chart selected rows, since this is the selected, it will take this. So this bar chart here, there are options there.
Thank you.
Vertical bar, horizontal bar, pie, and then word count. This is the, there are other options like create coded segment report. If I, this is for the frequency horizontal 45 degree. Maybe it will just change the orientation. There are some option of color change. All these you can explore, but generally these things are used in content. Content analysis is the quantitative analysis of qualitative data. Then you can use this option. I have not used these options since we are planning to do a content analysis, but till now I have not done it. Okay, so if it is clear to you up till this point, I hope. So I'll summarize once again. We have learned how to make category out of the existing code. You can either use the Excel sheet. You can import, you can give a command of print, and that print command, do remember that you have to give it in one row. So if I go to this, I will just close this. So this appears. So you go to the codes, you press this print codebook. In this codebook, keep the number of columns to one. And then here also, it will come as the Microsoft print to PDF. And then you press print. And then it will be saved. It will be saved. And then you copy, paste that in the Excel sheet. And in the Excel sheet, you have one column and make two, three columns for this category. You can start moving your codes to the category, and you can give the name. You can give the name to this category later if you are, nothing is coming to your mind, or you can do it simultaneously also if something is striking. And then again, you can go back to the QDA Miner Lite and use the option of edit code or drop down, selecting and dropping it down to the particular. If you have to make subcategory within the category, then again, you go to the codes, edit code. You can select any code, go to the codes, edit code, and give a down slash. So treatment strategy, give a down slash, and whatever like this thing you do, and you press OK. Then you see that this TYU, I've just typed some hypothetical name, it has appeared under this. Okay. And then again, you can use the option of code frequency. Okay. So I think you can use this. Should be, if you people agree, can we conclude the session now and you can practice these things at home? Codebook? Or you want a breakout room now? Or you can do one thing. You can shares open the breakout room for 10 minutes, because then again, once you practice it, it will be easy for you for 15 minutes. Yeah. Okay. That's good. I was also thinking that we should not be lazy. I should not be lazy because you have to do it. So sorry. So like the question which Dr. Surendar is asking, this is the, maybe this has come, this sentence, I want to code this patient client load. I'm just going random. So if you double click the existing code, this will appear here, patient client load. I think I forgot to show this command. So code you have to write only once. Now then you select this, and if this code you want to select, select this item, go and double click this. So this will appear here. Go here, staff nurse, select this, double click, this no experience of treating will appear here. So did you understand? So your same code you can use many times depending on the number of codes which you are getting. So you have to select and you don't have to write. Like if you want to use this mode of transmission, don't write mode of transmission. Go to the mode of transmission and double click this. This mode of transmission will appear here. Is it clear to you, Dr. Surendra, now?
Yes, ma'am. Very clear, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
Okay. Any other query from any other participant?
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yeah, Manisha?
Ma'am, in the Excel sheet, we have already done that coding and categorization. Then again, why are we doing in that software? I mean to say, what extra output we are getting from this QDA minor
line? Just a process. It will make your life easy because that code right now you did only for manual coding. You want to convey that for assignment purpose or you want to say for future manuscript writing?
Future only, I want to know that in the Excel, when you were demonstrating in the Excel, there itself you made the categories, you shifted the codes from there to the different categories. Then again, you are going back to the QDA minor Lite and then again.
Okay. Then how will you get the excerpt, that content, maybe not even for content analysis. Like if you don't have like this, I was showing you that statement because you have to support your statement also. How will you get that?
Okay, ma'am.
Like this analyze option, this coding frequency, many times you give this coding frequency also. Let me show you what is the difference. You just made the category there, but overall, like if you have to show the treatment strategy, you have to write a whole 2 pages on treatment strategy. How will you write that only based on that code? Then again, you have to select item and you have to give that code, what you say, that, let me show you. Maybe this one, not the treatment one, this. And then retrieve segment. And this retrieve segment, and here you can see, I forgot to show you the memo also. You can see here this one, this is the note. So you have to use this also while you are writing the manuscript. This memo, and you have to code this also. So for coding the memo, you can again copy paste this whole memo in a single document. You can export this like you have done for the one transcript and you can code that. Okay.
Okay, ma'am.
And memo also, you need to refer it to the memo for writing and then you will copy paste these segments also to support. You have seen that for every category, you support that justification of the category based on at least 4-5 quotes. So these quotes you will get it from here.
Okay.
Otherwise, how will you write it? It will be very difficult. Because right now only limited number of quotes are there. But if you do a transcript, this thing, and if the interview is very rich, an 18 to 20 transcript means almost 100 quotes.
Ma'am, another hypothetical question. I don't know whether it is right to ask or not. By now, many qualitative research might have been done. Then the softwares should have pre-decided codes. And from there we can... Means software should have a list of a huge number of codes. From there we can select this is okay for us or not, like that.
No, but this is that's why I said a qualitative, it is your interpretation. Quantitative, it can be done, but in qualitative, it is your interpretation. That's why a similar interview, if you give it to two people, if do their code books are entirely different. Like in that HIV article, which we will share it with you, me and the other person, Mohit, we did the coding and our thinking processes were entirely different. So it may be because he was from a different background, I was from a health background, and then, that thinking process will be entirely different. So it is the interpretation. That's how the purpose of all that realities and perspective we taught you in day one, that it is entirely different. So software cannot decide it. It is you who has to decide it. That's why you see in that Excel coding and also everything is decided by the researcher. That's why I said that researchers should give their perspective also. Because I am also getting biased. If something, like if I am the sufferer, maybe if just for hypothetical, if I am the, in my home, if I have experienced domestic violence and if I am doing a study on women health, domestic violence affecting the women's health, then I will be biased because, you know, I am, that has happened with me also. So that's why researchers should give their perspective also wherever, because that gives you a little feel. That why that particular tone or, you know, strength of the voice or choices, selection of the words will be different.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
One more question, ma'am. This
is yes, Hussain.
Ma'am, it's like a hypothetical
your
question.
Your turn will come after this. You have also raised your hand.
Yes, ma'am. This is a question regarding the interviewing, ma'am. If, for example, I've interviewed, have 8 interviews with me, and then I have got some 20 codes. Of that, 18 codes have saturated. Like for 18 codes, I've attained saturation, but the remaining 2 codes, I haven't attained saturation. So does it mean that I have to take some more interviews? What type of thing I can do if I haven't attained saturation for certain codes?
It is your call. It is again your call. Because in 18, if you have reached this, then the other 2 are a little, we can call it as an outlier. But you should include them, you should report them. Ideally, we say that if there is appearance of new theme, then you should take few more interview. So the practically see, it is up to you. If the time is limited, then you can include those 20 interview and you can give the analysis. You can report the same thing. But if the time, because many times that time is limited and you have to finish the project. In that case, if the time is there, then you can increase the number of interviews.
And the option of going back and doing the interview again to the patients or the participants, is it okay, ma'am? Like the second interview or third interview for the same
patient? The same person. No. You're not going to do the interview with the same person. You are going to interview a few more people. For new codes, not the same interview. Same person you take, I forgot to mention one more thing. When you said this, it struck to my mind that you should have the phone numbers of all the people whom you interviewed. Because if any query arises or if you're not getting clear, if you want to get back to those people just for clarification, you can go back. But you are not going to re-administer the interview guide to the same person.
Yes. Understood. Okay. Thank you.
Yes, Bhavna.
Ma'am, just a small query. What is the difference between these paid softwares and the free version that we are using? Are any of the steps shortened in the paid version?
Yes.
Because most of the things we are doing manually here.
No.
Is there an incentive of using a paid software? Should we go for it? Or if there is an option, should we explore?
I'll tell you. There are 2 things. Like in many places, people get learning resource allowance. So if you have those facility at your institute, and if you're planning to pursue your research in qualitative further, because see, everybody has their own purpose. There are people who want to do it only for few paper. You want to do extensive qualitative research. So if you are interested and if you want to pursue or as a researcher in this field, then I would recommend you can go for a paid software because it has got many options. And for the initial learning, you can use this free one. But for more advanced thing and to make all those diagrammatical thing, it is easy that even for there are more options also in the paid, the purchased one. But if you are just a flavor of the qualitative research, and if you don't want to spend, because the cost has also increased these days, I think, and Vivo cost around 70 and maybe the Atlas TI 50, but I don't remember exactly because we purchased it, I think 3-4 years back. So the current price, I'm not aware of, but initially what I would recommend that you do your few qualitative research with the help of these free software. And if you've already done it, with this free software, then you can go for a paid one if you want to pursue your research in quality.
Steps will be the same in the paid one also, except the analysis. the analysis would be advanced or a little easy, but these basic steps we have to go through in the advanced version.
Yes. NVivo also, it is not unlike quantitative. I am repeatedly saying, I may show you some of the options of NVivo. Maybe tomorrow we will try, or maybe some other day. There are options, but these whole process of coding, we did it in NVivo. NVivo, yes, exactly, line by line.
Exactly what I wanted to know. That there are no shortcuts.
No. Yeah. There are no shortcut, even neither in Netlist TI nor in... Only it will add some more flavor to it. But this process, what we are telling, or we have been doing it since yesterday, and we will be doing it tomorrow also, you cannot skip, even in the paid one.
Right. Got it. Thank you so much.
Okay, welcome. So if there are no questions, we are concluding today's session. So we will again meet tomorrow at 2 p.m. Thank you so much. Good day to all of you.